My dear children, how are you? I hope you are fine. Today we are going to see a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Basic Geometrical Ideas. Okay, chapter number 9. In this chapter, you are going to learn some new concepts. Okay, so listen to the class carefully. First, we are going to see about the concept of plane. What is meant by plane? Read the definition. A plane is a flat surface that extends endlessly in all the directions. Once again, read the definition. A plane is a flat surface that extends endlessly in all the directions. For example, take this board. Consider this board as a small plane. Now we are going to extend it. Extend the board in all directions. For example, if you extend this side, similarly if you extend this side towards down, similarly if you extend this side towards upward, similarly if you extend this side towards that side, you get a big surface, big flat surface. Such flat surface are said to be plane. I hope you understand. Once I give this definition, a plane is a flat surface that extends endlessly in all the directions. Okay. Next we are going to see point. What is mean by point? A point is so small that it has no length, no breadth and no thickness. It has no dimensions. A point specifies an exact location. We use point in your subject also. Which subject? Yes, in social. For representing some areas in maps. For example, if you represent Mumbai, Kolkata, you use a dot, a point to represent that location. We are telling that dot as a point. That a point is so small and it has no length, no breadth and no thickness. That's why we are saying it has no dimensions. A point specific and exact location. Okay. How we are represent the point? For example, suppose if you understand this as a point, you have to name this point by using capital alphabets A to Z. I am naming this point as A. Suppose you take some other point, name this point as D. Take some other point, name this point as Z. Take some other point, name this point as Y. Definitely you have to use the capital letter for representing the point. Do you understand? Okay. Next we are going to see line segment. What does mean by line segment? Listen carefully. It is perfectly straight at the shortest distance between two points. Suppose I am considering these two points A and D. Suppose I am joining these two points by using the straight line. I can also join these two points by using the line like this. I can also join the two points A and D by using the curved line like this. So this is also one of the way joining the two points A and D, and this is also one of the way joining the two points A and D, and this is also one of the way joining the two points A and D. Among these three ways, which is the shortest distance? Yes, this is the shortest distance. That's why we are saying it is a perfectly straight at the shortest distance between two points. Do you understand what I am saying? Line segment is nothing but a shortest distance between two points. The distance should be straight. Okay. Here you also have a model for line segment. See, this is a square. It is also a model for a line segment. Why? It has two end points. See here, the line segment has two end points. See here, this is one end point and this is another end point. This is also a model for a line segment. See here, this is also a model of a line segment. You can also do this model of your book. Okay. See, it has two end points. One more information, a line segment has a definite length. Okay. While you are asking about line segment means, you have to say line segment has two end points and it is the shortest distance between two points and it has definite length. We can also measure the length of this line segment. What is the length of this line segment? Yes, 30 centimeter. Okay. See here, it is a perfectly straight and shortest distance between two points. What are the two points? A and B. Okay. Next, we are going to see how to denote a line segment. See here. Now we are going to denote this line segment shortly. How we are going to denote? Listen carefully. What is the one end point A? What is the next end point B? So you have to write A and B together, and then above that letter you have to draw a small line segment like this. Do you understand? This is the representation of line segment. Suppose I am considering some other line segment XY. How do you represent this? Write the XY together, and above that letter you have to draw a small line segment like this. So this is the way you have to represent the line segment. Do you understand? Okay. Next, we are going to see a problem based on this concept line segment. Okay, read the question. Example 2. Name the four line segment in the given figure. This is the given figure. From this figure, we are going to write the four line segment. What is the definition of line segment? It has two end points. Observe this figure. What are the points here? This is one point M. This is another point O. This is another point N. This is another point O. So totally we have four points. Now we are going to write the name of line segment. Okay, what is the first line segment? MO or OM. Here we have written MO. Above that line, above that letter MO, you have to write a small bar like this. Okay, this is a line segment MO. That's why we have written this line segment. Next, ON. See here, ON. Next line segment is OL. We have finished the second one. See the third one, OP. Thus, we have finished the OP, third one. What is the last line segment? See here, this is the biggest line segment. MN, forget the O. MN is the biggest line segment. So, finally, fourth we have MN. Above the letter, you have to draw a small line segment. So, these are the four line segments we have written from the given figure. Okay. Next concept we are going to see, very important concept, is the rate. What is mean by rate? Suppose if you are taking a line segment, suppose think that this is a elastic one. Now if I extend this side, what will happen? It will go endlessly like that. If you extend one point of a line segment, it goes endlessly. Such type of situations are said to be rate. Now we are going to read the definition of rate. See here. A ray has a starting point and it goes endlessly in any one direction. See here, children, this is a line segment. It has two end points. You may extend this line segment in any one of the side, any one of the direction. This is one direction. This is another direction. If you extend this direction also, you may also extend this direction also. But you have to extend only in one direction. Such type of situation are said to be ray. See here, children. How do you differ a line segment and the ray? Observe the diagram. Here we have two end points. But in the case of ray, you have only one end point. To represent it extends endlessly, you should put the arrow like this. This is called an arrow. Okay, arrow one. So this side is extended endlessly. It was going on. To represent that situation, we have to put the arrow mark like this. So this is a ray PQ. How do you write the symbol in form like ray? By taking a starting point as a first letter and any other point of the ray as a second letter, and above the letters you have to draw a small ray like this. So this is the ray PQ. Do you understand? Next is the second one. Here, what is the starting point? Q. What is the, which side is extending? The side P is extending. So in that case, first you have to write Q only. Here you have to write Q. Why? Because Q is the starting point and P is the another point on that day. So here you have to write QP, and above the letters you have to put the arrow mark like this. See here, children, this is a line segment. If you extend this direction, you get one ray. Ray for to represent the ray, you have to put an arrow mark. See, here I have extended this direction. To represent this direction which is extended, you have to put the arrow mark. So this is line segment and this is a ray. I hope you understand the concepts both plane, line segment and ray. It's clear, children. Next, children, we are going to see a note on the concept tree. Okay. The first letter used for naming a ray must be the starting point of the ray. The second letter could be any point on the ray. Already I know explained this. See here, what they are saying in the note is, while you are naming their ray, first you have to write the starting point of the ray. You may call this point as a starting point, end point, initial point, fixed point. Okay, you may call this point as a starting point, end point, initial point, fixed point. So first point, if you are representing any ray, means first you have to write the name of the starting point and take any other point on the ray. I am taking this point as y and I am writing this as xy. So name of the ray is, name of this ray is xy, and above this letters you have to draw a small ray like this, small arrow mark like this. Okay, next see here, I am naming this ray as by using the letter xy, but here which is the starting point y. So first you have to write the letter y and then you have to write the letter x, and above that you have to put a small arrow mark like this. So this is the ray yx. So the ray yx, it means it starts from y and moves on x direction. The ray xy means it starts on x and moves on y direction. I hope you understand what is meant by plane and what is meant by line segment and what is meant by ray and what is meant by line. Next we are going to see what is meant by line. A line is obtained when a line segment is extended endlessly in both directions. Suppose this is a line segment. Now I am going to extend this both directions. Suppose someone holds this point and moves towards, and if he is moving go. Okay. Similarly, I am extending this direction also. So both the directions are extended endlessly. So to represent the situation, they are extended endlessly, we have to put arrow marks on both the sides of the line segment. See here, x, y, this is the line segment and this side is extended and this side also extended. So now we are going to read the definition of line. A line is obtained when a line segment, a line is obtained from a line segment is, a line segment is extended endlessly in both directions. The line segment has how many directions? Only two directions. If you extend these both directions, you get a line. Okay, do you understand what I am saying? This is a line segment. If you extend one direction, you get ray. If you extend both directions, you get line. How do you represent a line? Similarly, you take any point from the line x and y, any point from, any two points from the line, and write the name of that point, and above that letters you have to put a small line symbol for like this. Put two arrows on both the end of that line. So this is the representation of line. We understand this is the line xy. To represent a point, you have to use a capital letter. To represent a line segment, you have to write like this. To represent a ray, you have to write one arrow mark. To represent a line, you have to put two arrow marks on this. I hope you have understand how to represent a point, a line segment, ray and a line. Okay. Next we are going to see a small note. See here, length of ray and the line cannot be measured. What they are saying in this note? Length of ray and line. So the length of ray is extended in one direction endlessly, so we can't measure the ray. Similarly, line also extended in both direction, so we can't measure the length of ray and line. We understand. See the next one. line segment and the ray are called parts of a line. You know parts of the body. See, you say head, the hand, legs are called parts of the body. Similarly, what are the parts of the line? Parts of the line are line segment and the ray. Line and the line segment are said to be parts of a line. Suppose you have a line like this. If you cut this side, you get one ray. If you cut both the side, you get a line segment. That's why they are saying line segment and ray are called parts of a line. Okay, that's all this note. Next, we are going to see very very important concept, types of line. What are the types of lines? See the first one, intersecting lines. What is the next one? Concurrent lines. What is the next one? Perpendicular lines. And last, parallel lines. These are the types of lines we are going to see. What is the first one? Intersecting lines. What is mean by intersecting lines? See here. One more thing here you have to note, children. We can also use small letter to, a single small letter to denote a line. See here. This is one line. The name of the line is small l. See here, this is another line. The name of the line is small m. So we can also use small letter. You have to use only one letter. Okay, small one alphabet letter to denote a name of a line. So name of this line is L and name of the another line is M. Now we are calling these two lines as intersecting lines. Why we are calling them? See here. Two lines crossing over each other at a point O. O lies on L as well as M. L and M are said to be intersecting lines. See here, children, if two points cross over each other, then the lines are said to be intersecting lines. Suppose this is one line, think that this is a line and this is another line. They are crossing over at a point. So we are calling these two lines as a intersecting lines. Okay. See here, this is the line L and this is the line M. Both are crossing at a point O. That's why we are calling the line L and M are intersecting lines. And this point O is called point of intersection or intersecting points. The O is said to be point of intersection or intersecting point. Okay. So this O is called point of intersection. L and M are said to be intersecting lines. And the point O lies both the line L as well as in M. Okay. I hope you understand the concept intersecting lines. Next we are going to see concurrent lines. What is mean by concurrent lines? If three or more lines intersect at a point, then the lines are called concurrent lines. See here, if three or more lines, definitely minimum there should be three lines. If three or more lines intersect at a point, then the lines are called concurrent lines. Here we have how many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have taken 4 lines. These 4 lines are intersecting at a point. This point is said to be capital letter O. This point O is said to be point of concurrency or concurrent point. Here we are calling this point O as intersection point or point of intersection. Similarly, this intersecting point is said to be point of concurrency or point of concurrent. Okay. See here, this is the intersection point of these 4 lines. Okay. What are the name of the line? L, M, N, P. So we are calling the line L, M, N, P as concurrent lines. So what are the types of lines we have seen? One is intersecting lines and another one is concurrent lines. I hope you understand the concept intersecting lines and concurrent lines. It's clear, children? Next we are going to see perpendicular lines. What is mean by perpendicular lines? Two lines intersect at the right angle are called perpendicular lines. Perpendicular lines are also intersecting lines, but they should intersect at right angle. Then we call the lines as perpendicular lines. What is in the right angle? 90 degrees. Suppose see here, children. These are the two lines. Now we can say they are intersecting lines because the two lines meeting at a point. Then we can say they are intersecting lines. Suppose if they intersect at right angles. Right angles means 90 degrees. The angle between these two intersecting lines is 90 degrees. Means then we call these lines as perpendicular lines. Okay. See here. Here we have the two lines AB and PQ. They are intersecting at 90 degrees. So symbolically we can write the perpendicular line as PQ. We have to use this inverted T for the symbol for perpendicular. So AB perpendicular to PQ. This is the symbol for perpendicular. We understand. Next we are going to see parallel lines. What is meant by parallel lines? Two or more lines that do not intersect are called parallel lines. Two or more lines that never meet each other, that lines are said to be parallel lines. See here, this is one line, this is one line. They are going like this only. They never meet each other. Such lines are said to be parallel lines. In the board itself, we can find the parallel lines. See here, this is one line, this is one line. If we extend this line, it will going on. They never meet each other. Similarly, this is one line and that is one line. If we extend the border, they never meet each other. So parallel lines are, they never meet each other. So two or more lines that do not intersect each other are said to be parallel lines. What is the symbol for parallel lines? You have to draw two lines like this, like the modular symbol. So AB parallel to CD. See here, the name of this line is AB and name of this line is CD. See here, both are parallel, that is they never meet each other. They give constant distance between them. If you measure here, you find 2 centimeters. Wherever you find, the distance between the two lines should be same. So such lines are said to be parallel lines. The symbol for parallel line is like this. You have to put two one like this. This is the symbol for parallel and this is the symbol for perpendicular. See the next one, collinear points. In the 10th standard itself, you have the concept of collinear points. So listen carefully. What is meaning collinear points? Read the definition. If a line can be drawn through 3 distinct points, then the 3 points are called collinear points. If you can draw a line through 3 points, see here, these are the 3 points. We are able to draw a line through these 3 points, then we call these 3 points as a collinear point. See here, suppose if you have the 3 points like this, I can draw the line through only 2 points. I have to left this point alone. Suppose if I join like this, I get the 2 lines. But the condition is we have to use only one line to join the 3 points. Such points are said to be collinear points. Otherwise, we can say if 3 or more points lie on a straight line, then the points are said to be collinear points. Okay. So far we have discussed about plane, point, line segment, ray, line, and types of lines. Okay. Next, we are going to see problems from exercise 9.1. First one, true or false. A plane is a flat surface that extends endlessly in all directions. So, according to the plane definition, it extends in all directions. So, your answer is true. See the next one. A plane is named by 3 points on the plane which are collinear. We never explain the plane definition like this. So, this is false. See the next one. A point has no dimension. Already I told, a point has no thickness, no length, no breadth. It has no dimension. So here we have to write true. We use small case letters to write a name of the point. Already we are using the capital letter only for denoting the point. So this is your false statement. So here you have to write false. See the next one. A line segment has two end points. You know children already, a line segment is the smallest distance between, shortest distance between the two points. So it has two end points. So this is a true statement. So you have to write true. See the next one. A line segment is denoted by the symbol here. See here, this is the symbol for point, this is the symbol for ray, and this is the symbol for line, and this is the symbol for line segment. Here they give the symbol of line. So this is the statement false. So here you have to write false. See here, fourth question, subdivision A. How many end points does a ray have? See here, this is a ray. This is a ray. It has one starting point and it extends in another direction. So we can call this as a finishing end point, initial point, fixed point. In the question they are asking how many end points. So how many end points? Only one end point. So here you have to write one end point. Okay. Can the length of the ray can be measured? In the note itself I have given the length of the ray, length of the line cannot be measured. So you have to say no, the length of the ray cannot be measured. Okay. See the next one. Is ray is a part of a line? Already I have told line segment, ray are all part of the line. So here you have to write yes, ray is a part of a line. Line segment is also a part of the line. Okay. Next, see, does the ray PQ start from Q? See here children, already I have given a note. If you have the ray like this, means first you have to name this point, name this ray as, first you have to write the letter of the starting point P, and then any point on the ray, and then you have to put the ray symbol here. So this is the ray starting from P. In the question they are saying, does the ray PQ starts from Q? So this is no. So you have to write no. The ray PQ starts from the point P only. So you have to write no. The ray PQ starts from the point P. Do you understand, children? Next, see the fifth sum. Draw three rays AB, AC, and AD. They are asking us to draw the three rays, and the name of the rays are AB, AC, and AD. So which is the starting point? A. So first we are drawing like this. Here you have to write A, because in this way A is the starting point and B is any point on the ray. So you have to name like this. See, this is ray AC and this is ray AD. You can also draw the three rays like this, because the three rays have the same starting point A. So AB, AC, AD, AB, AC, AD. These are also three rays. Okay, see the next one. How many lines can be drawn through first one, A, one point M? They are asking through one point, how many lines can be drawn? For example, take this is your one point. First I am drawing the line like this. Next I am drawing the line like this. Next I am drawing the line like this. So similarly, we can draw many lines. So we have to write through the point M, we can draw many lines. Do you understand, children? Through a point, we can draw many lines. See the next question. Two points A and B. First you have to read the question. How many lines can be drawn through two points A and B? They are asking through the two points A and B. These are the two points A and B. Through these points, the line should be passed both A as well as B. So a line should pass both A and B. How many lines can you able to draw? We can draw only one line through A and B. See the spaces of sum. Consider the given figure and write down the sets of collinear points. By observing this figure, you have to write the sets of collinear points. See here, according to the definition of collinear, if three points lying are stated, such points are said to be collinear points. Three or more points also said to be collinear points. See here, we have two lines. On this line, we have F, E, G, and I, F, H. These are the points we are having on these two lines. So first we are going to write the first set of only points. Consider this line. Along this line, how many points are there? 3 points. 1, 2, 3. So we can call these 3 points as a only points, right? F comma E comma G. Consider the next line. Along this line, how many points are there? H, E, and I. So write I comma E comma H. These are the two sets of collinear points. I hope you understand all the concepts we have discussed today. Write your class up very neatly and do your homework correctly. Okay, thank you.